Mark? Oh, God. Hello? Mac. No, you didn't wake me. Oh, well, not long. But... Really? Oh, no, that's great, Mac. The sooner you get through this, the better for all of us. I'm really glad you're going to stay, Mac. Listen, Kieran's crying. I better go to him. The surgery is fine. Don't worry. Okay, bye. Love you.
What Bellings can offer you is a state-of-the-art office facility. It's a ground-up service, from the choice of carpets to the light shades in the executive loo. Yeah, we deal with all the major manufacturers, and our unique relationship with them is passed on to you in terms of saving. Yeah, and that quote you've got in your hand there is so cutting-edge, makes my wallet bleed.
Well, it certainly is a competitive quotation.
Well, that's Bellings for you, Mr. Channing. An old family company we may be, but we've got the vision and the spherical objects to mix it with the big boys and come out on top. Senonet Plastics' new office building will be the envy of all your competitors and will be a pleasant and productive working environment for your staff. You can rest assured. And, Miss Grant, if you tell me your favourite colour of carpet right now, I'll knock another 5% off the bottom line. And I'll lay the carpet myself. How about it? Hot in here, isn't it? I can do you a great deal on air conditioning if you like.
Jude. My life is in boxes. Beth's fallen in love with a new bathroom, and I gave up waiting in line when I left my parents' house. What time's my first patient?
8:40.
Oh, great.
Shall I call the intensive hair unit?
Morning.
Morning.
Great hair. Oh, just a whim. Anything pressing?
No, mail's on your desk.
Thanks.
She got out of the right side of the bed today. Great hair.
Oh, come on. Anything would be an improvement on the Darth Vader she had before.
Hey, son!
Where have you been? You've been out before 7.
Securing our future. They've signed! This is the big one. Holidays. Where do you fancy? Barbados, Mauritius. Mm. No. Hello, Raymond Bellings' office. Oh, Mr. Rossini.
Hello. Benny.
The car?
Riverside Surgery.
Could
you please give a message to Dr. Kwame?
Look, I'll get one of my oiks to drive it over straight away. Surcharge? No problem at all. Mr. Rossini, ciao.
I feel naked. You, however, look great today. What, as opposed to yesterday?
Oh, I didn't mean that.
I'm only teasing.
No, but how do you do it? I mean, you manage this place, you cope with the baby, I move house and everything falls apart.
Max away.
Hello, Mrs. Belling.
Hello, Dr. Kwame. He's in the back garden.
Right. Oh. Hello, Mr. Belling.
Hello, Doc. Gutters, eh?
How are things?
Can't stop, Doc. You should see the state of it up here.
Yes, I know. Mine are the same. Look, why don't you come down, have a cup of tea, so we can talk properly. How are you feeling?
Top of the world, if you pardon the pun.
And how are you finding the medication?
I feel fine, Doc.
Raymond, you do know that it's the medication that makes you feel fine. And if you stop taking it, it'll make you ill again. It's a vicious circle.
He's been complaining about the side effects. He's been getting blurred vision really badly. And if he can't drive the car, he won't take the tablets. He loves to drive.
Why would I swap feeling like this for feeling like a drugged-up junkie, huh? You never see junkies cleaning gutters, do you? Not unless there's some lead to nick for the next fix. Doc, I feel fine. I clinched a deal this morning which will put us back where we belong. Right at the top! Oh, thanks, Doc. You saved the NHS a hefty sum there. You might get a rebate.
Hello, Mr. Hughes. You're very early.
Thank you.
Who's on the rotor for Mr. Hughes today?
Jude.
How's Faith bearing up?
Oh, she isn't really. She hugs pillows, you know. Found chocolate wrappers in the bin. Hope I don't ever get to the pillows and chocolate stage.
Mm, poor thing.
I can't believe that a mere man would get in the way of Faith and her nursing. Not like this.
No. When Ben gets back in, tell him I want a word with him.
The last two admissions you had were both down to you not taking your medication. Can't you see the connection?
I'm still taking my medication. I am. Just not as much as I was prescribed, that was all. Everything was blurring and I was putting on weight. Carol had to roll me out of bed.
There are alternatives to lithium. Why don't I speak to Dr. Gordon? Get him to bring your outpatient appointment forward.
I don't need to see a psychiatrist.
Is everything all right?
Everything's fine. Okay, Raymond, I'll speak to Dr. Gordon on your behalf. I can't force you to take your medication, but I'd like you to at least think about the consequences if you don't.
Well, everything's tickety-boo. And don't you worry about a thing, Doc. I've got some imperative DIY to attend to. Excuse me.
I'll ring Dr. Gordon as soon as I get back. I know it's a great temptation to think that he's well and he doesn't need it anymore, but please make sure that he takes his medication properly.
Yes, I'll try. But he never listens to me, even at the best of times. Do you think we'll keep him out of hospital this time?
That's a plan.
Okay, and I'll see you next week.
Ciao, Doc.
Okay. Katrina said that was your last patient. Look, sorry about the mess in the bathroom this morning. I didn't know you knew so many rude words.
Just let me in first tomorrow, yeah?
I was about to go into town. Thought we could be ladies who lunch.
Come on, Beth. The only time you ever ask me to lunch is to tell me bad news or to ask me something you'd find easier in a public place. So which is it? And to be honest, I could do without the bad news.
Yeah, okay, you got me. I wanted to ask you something. So how about lunch and a spot of Dutch courage?
Well, I'd love to, but this place is a pigsty. I want to get it tidied up before afternoon surgery. I have to have some order in my life somewhere.
Okay, I wanted to borrow some money.
No, no problem. My purse is in my bag.
No, I mean money with a capital M. I think it's about time I put down some roots. Leatherbridge is as good a place as any. I thought you might be able to lend me the deposit for a flat.
You are joking.
Oh, no, come on, Jude. It'll be great. Look, I won't be occupying the bathroom anymore. I won't be getting under your feet.
Wait a minute. You once said if the world had constipation, Leatherbridge is where they'd have to stick the suppository. And now I'm supposed to believe that you want to put down roots here?
I mean it. Please, Jude.
I can't. I'm sorry. I'm saving for my own place. I'm not exactly rolling in it. No. No.
Well, you don't ask, you don't get.
Well, look, how about we go for lunch then?
It's all right. I'm not hungry anymore.
Beth!
Where is he?
Come in, why don't you?
Hello, sis.
Don't sis me.
Would you like a cup of tea, Catherine? Or is this just a shouting at your brother visit?
Do you know what you've done?
Made us a tidy sum, I imagine. Sunderland Plastics are an emerging company. Up 4p yesterday.
I have been taking calls for Mr. Channing all morning. He thinks he's got the bargain of the century. We can't fill this order.
It's the biggest deal I've ever done. It's a monster.
Raymond, you don't work for us anymore.
And half my commission.
There will be no commission, you idiot! I have lost a potential customer because of your insane interfering. Are you taking your medication? Is he? It's your job to make sure that he does, so that he doesn't ruin everything for the rest of us. I've lost thousands on this. Well, maybe a recession doesn't mean anything to you lot on state handouts, but it means a great deal to a small company like mine.
But technically, the company's Raymond's too. It was left for both of you.
Raymond has been removed as a director, hasn't he? Well, if this carries on, there will be no company.
I'll put the kettle on anyway.
Can I have a word?
Sure. What can I do for you?
Faith.
Oh.
Katrina says she's very low.
It's not really my problem.
No? Riverside is about to lose a very good nurse because you mix business with pleasure.
She did a fair bit of mixing herself.
I don't think Mac's going to be very pleased about it when he gets back. Relationships between work colleagues are a mistake at the best of times.
Except if your name's Mac or Kate. Sorry. Cheap shot.
I want this situation resolved before Mac gets back. All it takes is for you two to be professional about this.
I'd be nothing but professional.
I want you to go and speak to her.
And you think she's going to listen to me?
Will you do it?
Yes. All right. But I'll let you know, it's not going to do any good. I don't know what to say.
Tell her you're sorry and you want her to get back to work.
Oh, is that all? Why do I feel as if I haven't got a choice in this?
Because you don't.
Great, caught you.
Sorry, later.
How long has he been off the tablets?
He's not off the tablets. He's just reducing the dose. You don't know what they do to him. He feels drugged all the time.
And the alternative is to let the business go down the tubes because Raymond is a bit drowsy. I think not. He's a manic depressive, Carol. He can't control his emotions. He needs the medication.
Look, you think I don't know that after 15 years? All you're worried about is your precious business. Everything else has to come before Raymond yet again. What about his feelings?
It's my livelihood.
And ours means nothing.
I'm calling Dr. Gordon.
There's no need. He'll be here at 12:30 with Dr. Kwame.
Thank God. Well, then at least we might be able to get something done about getting Raymond admitted into the psychiatric unit.
Well, Dr. Kwame thinks we'll be able to look after him at home with the correct support.
We'll see about that.
Ben Kwame.
Jack Gordon. So fill me in.
I was called out early this morning by Mr. Belling's wife. He's not taking all his medication. Getting a little bit grandiose.
He tends to break down very quickly.
Well, I don't think it's as serious as that. He's having problems with the side effects, though.
When Raymond is off his medication, we both know how enthusiastic he can be. I wouldn't want the police dropping him on my doorstep in the kind of condition he was last time. He assaulted three nurses.
I can appreciate that, Dr. Gordon. I really can. But if we could stave off an admission, I think it'd be best for both parties.
A risk is a risk, even if it's a therapeutic risk.
I don't think we need to overreact.
I don't think I am. Shall we?
At last.
Hello, Raymond. Catherine.
I hope now we can get this mess sorted out.
Steady on, sis.
I think my brother needs to be sectioned and taken into hospital.
Can we slow down, please?
Are you a psychiatrist?
I'm Dr. Kwame, Raymond's GP.
Oh, yes. The so-called doctor who came here this morning and did nothing. Dr. Gordon is Raymond's psychiatrist. I'll deal with him.
I'd like to spend some time with Raymond, please. If we could be alone for a few moments.
Can I interest you in an executive chair?
Come. Okay, hello. How are you?
Good. Thanks for listening yesterday.
Oh, it's my pleasure, really.
Well, I didn't want to give the impression that I was just whinging.
Not at all. No, we all need someone to sound off to once in a while. Look, I hope you didn't mind me leaving, well, letting myself out. Just that you look so peaceful, I didn't want to disturb you.
Do you always have that effect on women?
Alas, yes. Dr. Mark Elliott, human anaesthetic.
That massage, well, I haven't slept as well in weeks. You've a real talent, you know. Maybe we should open a stress clinic.
What, for the staff or the patients?
Things to do.
Yeah. See you later.
You can't cope with him.
It's not about coping with him. It's about living with him. And I want him here with me.
And to hell with the rest of us.
That's not what I meant, and you know it.
The longer we can keep someone in their home environment, the better. It guards against institutionalisation and stigmatisation.
And what about the stigmatisation of my institution? My competitors will be laughing their socks off when they get to hear about this.
I understand there have been difficulties for you. But the last two times Raymond was admitted, he went into a deep depression.
At least he was out of my hair.
Oh, typical.
He's obviously not on enough medication.
What we really should be looking at is the lowest possible maintenance dose because the side effects simply lower the patient's quality of life too far. It's a delicate balance.
At last.
I honestly think it would be wise to err on the side of caution. Admit Raymond compulsorily. He's refusing informal admission.
Oh, no.
Good.
Sorry, I don't agree.
What?
I appreciate your concerns, Dr. Gordon, and I bow to your superior experience. But I think erring on the side of caution would seriously damage his mental health.
I don't think we need your opinion.
But I am going to give it. And I am needed to sign my half of the Section 2 papers. In my professional opinion, with increased community support and monitoring, Raymond can stay out of hospital.
I appreciate your input, Dr. Kwame. I have known Raymond longer than you have. I know how quickly things deteriorate.
I'm not trying to second-guess you, Dr. Gordon.
I've known Raymond longer than all of you. I think Raymond is a danger to himself and others. That's the criteria for sectioning, isn't it?
Ostensibly.
The only danger he's been today is to your bank balance. I would very much like him not to be admitted, at least not yet. And I will get him to take his tablets, I promise.
I'm not fully convinced that this is the best course of action. But if you're willing to monitor Mr. Belling...
Yes, of course.
We review in 1 week's time. Agreed?
Yes.
No, I demand you admit him. I have a legal right to have my brother admitted to a mental hospital.
The right to rest with the next of kin.
I want him to stay at home here with me.
I don't believe this.
I'll see you out.
Call me if there's any problems.
And make sure he takes his medication.
Thank you. I will.
Kate, any news, any more news about Faith?
Katrina doesn't think she's coping at all well.
No, good practice nurse is hard to come by.
Exactly. I've asked Ben to go round and speak to her. Maybe he can persuade her to come back.
That's a good idea.
Do you think so?
Yes, I'm sure Mac would approve. And we could have Faith back at work before he returns. Well done.
Don't worry about Catherine, babes. The deals I've got planned keep her happy.
I've not been avoiding you. I've just been rushed off my feet. Look at my legs. They're 3 inches shorter than they were this morning.
Well, that's not what it feels like to me, however short you get.
OK. I'm all yours. What do you want to talk about?
Faith.
Oh, not you as well.
What?
Well, everybody wants to talk about Faith. I mean, Katrina's given me the sob story, Kate's turning the screw, and Mark, you've got to sort it out, old chap. And now you. I thought we had more interesting things to talk about.
I'm not comfortable with this situation, that's all.
What is there to be uncomfortable about? There is no situation. Faith just thought there was more to it than there was. And now she's got the hump, and she's having an attack of the Scarlet O'Haras. It was just a crush. That's all. Nothing heavy. Now it's over. End of story.
Mm-hmm. I reckon in a few weeks they'll be begging me. I finished the kettle. Finished it.
You're deadbeat, aren't you? It's too much excitement in one day. Why don't you go and sit down for a while? I'll get on with the dinner.
Good idea. I'll just...
If it was a crush, nothing heavy, why has Faith resigned? And why is Kate putting pressure on you to get her to come back? She must think you still have some influence on her.
Because she wants me to sort it out.
And what is there to sort out? How can you if you've got no sway over Faith?
Okay. Maybe it was a bit more than a crush. Maybe. She got too claustrophobic, obsessive. And I didn't handle it very well. And we parted on bad terms. There's still a hangover. And I think I should try and clear it up for the good of the practice, nothing else. Kate thinks I shouldn't mix business with pleasure.
Oh, that's just great.
What?
What's she gonna say when she finds out about us?
Dinner's ready, love. Ray? Ray? Oh, Ray!
Dr. Kwame?
Yes, Katrina?
I've just had the casualty officer from St. Phil's on the phone. One of your patients, Mr. Belling, he's just been admitted.
What's wrong?
Overdose.
I'll leave a jug of water over here for him. Will you make sure that he gets plenty to drink? Okay. Thanks.
He needs plenty of fluid to flush the lithium out of his system. They've checked his kidneys. They seem to be working well. But he will need to be monitored for the next 24 hours.
Well, I hope you two are pleased with yourselves. I told you he was unstable. Now he's taken an overdose. If you'd have listened to me, he wouldn't be here in the first place.
If we'd have listened to you, we'd have locked him up years ago and thrown away the key.
And this is a better alternative?
Hiya. Something smells good.
I thought it'd be nice to cook something special so we could celebrate moving into our new home.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. About the money thing? It's just so unexpected.
So you've changed your mind?
No, I haven't. I'm just glad you're being so cool about it.
Are we into the bar?
Oi!
And soak it all away.
Oh, you know, I could get used to having you around.
Do-gooders like you make me sick. My brother's lying at death's door because you were too stubborn to listen to someone who knows him better than you do.
Mrs. Crozier, I had your brother's best interest at heart.
As long as it fitted in with your bleeding hearts agenda. You haven't heard the last of this. I shall be speaking to your superiors.
Ray, why didn't you tell me, you silly man?
You're in hospital, Mr. Belling.
Thought the place looked like it had been decorated.
You took an overdose of your medication.
An overdose? No, no.
I don't understand.
Catherine said if I took my medication, there might be a place for me back in the business. I mean, it wouldn't be on the board. Not straight away, Asis. I think I just got a bit carried away. I wanted to get better as fast as possible. Get us off the social. I think Barbados. Don't you, love?
So that's what you were saying to him. You thought you could get him to stay out of your hair by promising him a job.
I just wanted him to take his tablets.
In his euphoric state, he took what you said at face value. He reasoned that the more tablets that he took, the quicker he'll get better. People in his condition could be highly suggestible.
All he ever wants to do is to impress you, Catherine. Just to know that you think he's worthwhile. That you care about him, don't you see that?
Steady on, love. Don't want her to change her mind about having me back.
But she was lying to you.
Rubbish. You wouldn't do that, would you, sis?
Naughty Daddy won't be able to wake you up tomorrow morning, not like today. Come on, sweetheart.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no harm done, eh?
No harm done. You could have died.
But I didn't, did I? How about that job, then?
Mrs. Crozier, perhaps there might be some lighter task your brother can do from home. When he's much better, of course.
I'm game.
Well,
nothing too taxing. Just enough to keep him occupied.
Yes, I suppose so.
I don't think we'll be able to do Barbados. Skegness.
Right. I better be off.
I think I owe you an apology, too.
Forget it. You've had a tough day. You might want to see your doctor about anger management. Might make you feel better.
Thank you.
Don't forget to give me a call when you want your gutters done.
I'll be in touch.
Can you get that for me? Okay.
Ringing. Unknown number.